I'm Eric with AquaSpy, and we're just going to run through the installation on our system here. Starting out, everything comes in a kit already for you. The only thing that you need is a T-post. So the probe, the comm tower, and the extension pole and cable and hose clamps and everything you need are in there. The comm tower has two parts to it, a bracket. And I've already put one together so you can look at it for time purposes. And also we have bird spikes on the top to keep birds from doing their business on the solar panel. We have a 48-inch probe. And attached to that, we have the extension cable. And we just bundle this up here to protect this cable. And this cap goes over it. And I have one put together there. For our system, we use a slurry, so we've already dug the hole. You can use a power auger with a 2-inch bit and an extension to get you down to 4 foot, or you can use a manual auger that soil companies make to get you down. Eloy is the manual auger. After we dug the hole, we can use the soil from the hole, or we can use topsoil if the ground's a little too wet. And we just take that soil and we sift it into a bucket. I have a 2-gallon bucket here with probably a quarter full of topsoil already sifted. I can pour some in this. You want to get a pancake batter consistency. Pancake batter, enough water on the top so it moves around so we can get it out of the bucket. We're going to put the slurry in the hole first. And then we're going to insert the probe. And as I'm putting the probe in the ground, I'm going to move it in a circular direction. That way the slurry comes up around the probe, eliminates any air gaps, and keeps trash from coming down, and keeps water from taking the least path of resistance and giving you false readings. So as you can see, we have slurry around the whole probe. Any excess slurry, we just do a little gardening. We want to leave the site just like we found it. We do not want too much excess slurry, and we do not want not enough in there to create kind of a hole. Now I'm going to hook the probe up to the comm tower, which is already set up here. This system is plug and play. This is only one cable and one little power plug that turns the unit on. There'll be a nice little lady that comes on telling you she's looking for the probe. When she finds the probe, then she'll start by attaching itself to the network, searching for GPS coordinates, searching for
probe detected.
So now the probe's detected and it's cellular based, so it's going to make a call and try and get connected to the network. All while you're doing this, you can be cleaning up from installation And that thing, and the system will continue to just run. And when it attaches itself and says data upload complete, it is already connected to the network and is already using data. Just giving it a little time here. How am I on time? Pretty good?
About 8 minutes.
What's your depth levels of moisture reading, or is it just one for the whole probe?
So it's a 48-inch probe, and there's a sensor every 4 inches, starting at 4 all the way down to 48. So each sensor is measuring not only soil moisture, but EC, tracking bulk salts in your profile, and temperature at every level, as well as the roots as they grow through during the season. Okay, so it sang a nice little tune, and it's already collecting data now. It's collecting raw data from the probe, and it will collect every 5 minutes. The comm tower will hold 4 15-minute logs of data, and then next hour it will call out with the next slew of data. From this point, we take this field that we've already set up, is given a 4-digit field ID number, and we take the serial number off the orange comm tower, excuse me, and we input them in our software called AquaSpy, and that marries the equipment with the field together. And the nice part about that is we can see I don't know if you can see the screen, but it's showing the installation we just did. It has every sensor value from 1 to 12. All of our numbers are within each other. They're in 50s and 40s. So we got a good installation. We do not have any air pockets anywhere. If we were to have an air pocket, or if we did not have enough slurry, one of those lines would be red, indicating that we have more air than soil around that sensor. And we have the geo location, the Latin long, and the probe number that it's connected to. You just hit finalize there, and the process is done. Any questions?
How do you calibrate those numbers to moisture content?
It's already calibrated when it leaves the factory, so no calibration is needed. It's calibrated in 100% air, 100% water. 100% being fully saturated in a bathtub of distilled water, and zero meaning we're holding it out of here in bare air. So your soils will indicate where they are on that scale. Your clays and your loams are going to be higher if they're really saturated, 70s and 80s. Your lighter soils, like your sands, are going to be down in your 30s and 40s. So that's where we are with this field.
Soil?
No, because we're measuring past that. It's all relative. Yeah. We're not trying to find a volumetric number for you. We're just reacting to what the plant tells us. So as that slurry dries on the graph, you're going to have true readings with what the field is telling you, the rest of the field. You would install it in the plant line in between two healthy plants. Mm-hmm.
Segment 200 completed.